Welcome to Brusilov Keep. This is the second map coming to the In the Name of the Tsar DLC for Battlefield 1. This map is currently running on the CTE, and it is just mobbed. The servers are completely full. It seems players are really excited to try out this new map. And this is just the start of what DICE is planning for the CTE over the next few weeks. More Russian maps are coming to the servers, along with other brand new things that are going to need to be tested by the community. However, my first impression of Brusilov Keep, this is a really good infantry map. On Conquest, which is the game mode running right now on the CTE, that might change, it might stay the same. It's a four-flag layout. Two flags close to the deployments of the Russian and the Austro-Hungarian armies. The C point up in the hills towards the top of the map, and that's concealed in like this rocky cavern. And then the B point in between the two bridges on this map. One of the bridges houses train tracks for the armored train behemoth, and the other is a road which can be used by vehicles, but it's rather exposed. Infantry can sit on it as well, but it can be looked right onto by houses that sit all around it. The brand new Putilov armored truck, I think it's the Putilov, it might be Putilov Garford. I didn't get a chance to drive in it, but I saw it driving round the map. That is available on this map now. And DICE has decided to add most of the new weapons into the CTE as well. That means we have two variants of the Maxim SMG, two variants of the Fedorov Avtomat, two variants of the double barrel shotgun, the General Liu rifle, again two variants, the MG14 Parabellum, two variants there, the Vitterli rifle, which is the second bolt action rifle coming to the Scout class, two variants of that, the Mosin Nagant rifle, again two variants, and the Nagant revolver, which is an all-kit sidearm. That's a lot of weapons to be trying out, and I think in the three rounds that I've played so far, and then I stopped to come and make this video, I wasn't actually killed by, you know, a standard base game weapon or any of the They Shall Not Pass weapons either. Everyone was using the brand new weapons because there are so many of them that you can choose from. But straight off the bat, the Maxim SMG, that thing is just awesome. I've got a feeling that DICE are going to need to do a little bit of tweaking to this thing because at the moment, it is very, very powerful, even at long range. It's got a slower rate of fire than some of the other SMGs, but it's got a really, really cool reload. Now, in real life, this would have reloaded its box magazine via stripper clips being slotted into the box one by one. But DICE has slightly simplified it so that you just slide all of the clips in and all of the clips out when you want to reload it at once instead of individually. Could you imagine the time it would have taken to do each of those individually? It would have been insane. However, back to the map, Brusilov Keep is focused around this large frozen river that runs right across the center of the map, which separates the two sides. Both of the bridges are extremely exposed, so I wouldn't suggest using them to cross over the river. Go down into the riverbed instead. Down in this lower area, there are plenty of rocks to use as cover, but it turns into just a proper infantry battleground. I'd say it's very similar to how Argonne Forest works. The B flag that sits right here can be captured from on the bridge or underneath it, and that means gameplay can move around all the time rather than the map becoming a sniper fest over the bridge because it cuts the lines of sight down perfectly for those closer range weapons. And because you're slightly lower down, you're fairly well concealed from some of the houses that surround the river. The A point on the Russian spawn side is set out as like this makeshift trench area, and it has a really small capture radius, and that encourages players to come in closer and fight it out in these trenches. They're rudimentary, they're not proper trenches like you'll see on some of the French maps in the game, but they're dug into the ground a little bit and they do provide a little bit of cover. You can see into the area from outside it, so if you want to use rifles, then you can pick people off. But because the trenches are dug into the ground, people can hide out of sight in there. Outside of the capture point, it is actually fairly exposed. There's a lot of snow around the outside, but as you move further away, there's some trees off in the distance, some larger rocks, and you can use those as cover as you try to get towards the middle of the map. Now, over the other side, the D point by the Austro-Hungarian spawn, This is more of an urban setup. It's actually connected to the rest of the town that you end up fighting in near the river. Again, like the A point though, it does have a small capture radius, and that limits players from just camping in buildings so they can take the objective, although there are a few buildings within the capture radius. They can be destroyed, so it might be wise at the start of the round to just smash a few walls down with your rocket gun before you move off into the center of the map. Now, considering that Brusilov Keep is fairly small and it focuses heavily on infantry play, I was actually surprised to see there are plenty of opportunities for longer range gunfights with rifles and scope semi-auto rifles. Because of the way the map rises up towards the C capture point, and it rises up even higher towards the A point by the Russian spawn, you can get a good view of what's going on down below in the town. However, DICE has done a really good job to restrict the view from higher up down into the town by placing these really large, substantial buildings either side of the river crossing. They provide some really good cover for the infantry that are trying to take the B point. And trust me, as soon as one team starts to try and take the B point from the other team, it's just like little ants watching them run over your minimap. They'll come spewing over the bank into the riverbed, and it just causes absolute chaos. The map only supports one proper vehicle per team, so this is not a map that I think that vehicle players are going to enjoy very much, but other maps in the DLC like Galicia are promised to be much more open, large expanses of open space, and that will allow for some vehicle fighting. Now, horses make an appearance on this map, as they will do, I think, on every single map in the DLC, but I'm not really sure what effect they'll have here on Brusilov Keep. Because of the way the map is actually designed, you're essentially fighting over a riverside town. Use of the cavalry charging feature with the lance, where you sort of zoom in and charge at the soldiers, that's not going to be ideal in an urban setting, essentially. You might get away with it on the outskirts of the town, but most of the action is going on around that river. Lots of players are going to be aware that there's a horse approaching because, of course, all the infantry are quite close together, and you're going to be targeted very, very quickly. I'd suggest it would be more sensible to switch back to the saber and then use swipes to try and take out the infantry rather than locking yourself into a charge that's more than likely going to get you killed. Elite classes are available on the map as well. I spotted the Flame Trooper and the Sentry running around in a few matches that I played, but no sign yet of a specific Russian elite class. I'm starting to think that DICE might not be adding an elite class with this DLC. They never confirmed that an elite class would 100% arrive with each DLC. Instead, on the Battlefield website, they simply say new elite classes. Perhaps that's specifically vague? Well, whatever the case might be, the Flame Trooper works best around the banks of the river in the houses. The flames in confined spaces will literally roast players to death. And the Sentry, I think, is best deployed in the riverbed itself because of the huge numbers of players that he'll be able to spray bullets onto. Overall, Brusilov Keep is a great infantry map. It's not an excellent infantry map, and this is just my personal opinion here, but it is extremely frantic, and sometimes that can actually detract from the gameplay. There is almost no relent in the action whatsoever, and I found it a little bit frustrating in certain places that I could never really sort of just stand still for 2 seconds, reload my gun, without having to pay attention to about 5 different angles all at once. I just wanted to check my surroundings, reload my gun and move on, but there were some instances where I just could not do that. It's a map I feel could actually benefit from being a tiny bit bigger to perhaps stretch out the gameplay and give you some of those breaks in the motion. However, because this map is fully textured now, I don't really see the DICE developers making any major changes at this point. Lukau Pass is also a mainly infantry map, so let's best hope the next map that DICE show us on the CTE incorporates some of those vast expanses of the Eastern Front, breaks up the gameplay a little bit, and bring some vehicles into the mix. But there you go, that's your first look at Brusilov Keep, the second map now revealed for the In the Name of the Tsar DLC. Thanks very much for watching the video. Let me know what you think of Brusilov Keep down in the comments section. Is this going to be a map for you? Are you an infantry player? Or are you waiting for something bigger, more vehicle focused in this DLC? let me know down below and I'll be there reading as many as I can. But until next time, my name is Westy and I'll catch you guys in the next video.